Good morning, guys. I just wanted to do kind of like a vlog for you. First off, didn't get a second video up on my YouTube channel for you last week. I'm sorry about that. I was going to do the second part of the beginner guide, but I wasn't able to film it. So, just, we're here now. It's Monday. To vlog a little bit like this. I haven't done a vlog where I actually like talk to the camera for a while. I've just been like getting workouts put out there for you guys, and I kind of like doing videos like this because I interact with you guys even though y'all really aren't there. I'm talking to a camera, but I just feel like it's more personal, and that's kind of how I want my channel to be. Is, you know, I want you to see that I'm a real person, that I do have a voice, and I want to share it on my channel, not just want to put workouts out there with just music and no talking or anything like that. So, and it just turned exactly 11. I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I just woke up. My alarm clock went off this morning at 7, but I guess I hit the off button, because on iPhones you can either hit, I don't remember what it is, but you can either hit snooze or you can hit stop, and apparently I hit stop without realizing it, and it didn't come back on, so I slept in, didn't even know it. But I am kind of glad because I was tired. I'm still tired. My boyfriend has been getting up like 4 in the morning because he has to go to the office, which they've moved about an hour and a half from us. If you don't know, my boyfriend is a pipeliner, so he has to report to the office every now and then during the week. So we are discussing on moving, because getting up at 4 about 5 days a week is really not ideal for him. It's, you know, he works a lot, he has a lot of stress, he needs his rest. So, anyways, he got up at 4 o'clock this morning and it woke me up, and for some reason, when he gets up that early, like, I can't go back to sleep. I just can't. He's not there, and I just have a hard time going back to sleep. So this morning, he left at like 4 something, and I was still awake at like 6:30. I tried to play on my phone, turn the TV on, I tried to make myself tired and like go back to sleep, but I couldn't. So I guess finally I did make myself tired and I went back to sleep, and when my alarm went off I turned it off, so that's why I slept in till 11. So the only thing I have done before I started recording this video is brush my teeth and put my hair up and put my workout clothes on. So I have no makeup on. This is the real me, all out. As you can see, I think I've said this before, the reason why I wear makeup is because I usually spray tan, so my face is like 10 times lighter than my skin. Oh well, I don't care. But anyway, so yeah, so I wanted to start vlogging this morning because, you know, I didn't have a good Monday. I really like to get up early on Mondays. Not really early, like 8:30, 9, something around that area. But I like to get up and really start my week and, like, you know, set the tone for the rest of the week. Mondays I usually do shoulders, chest, and triceps. And It's a really easy workout. I usually do a 15 to 20 minute HIIT cardio after I'm done, so it's really like quick workout. I'm not there all day. On Monday, I can get to come home, relax, do whatever I want for the rest of the day, but not when you get up at 11 o'clock. Kind of cut your day off. So, I got up tired this morning, and of course I always love going to the gym, but as you can see on my social media, Instagram, almost everything is about the gym because I'm always there. I live and breathe through the gym or anything that has to do with health or fitness, because that's what I love, that's what I enjoy. But I just want to share with y'all that there's some days that, you know, I don't have that extra motivation to, you know, just jump out of bed and go to the gym. I'm real just like everyone else. I do have sometimes some challenges. Sometimes I'm tired more than other days. Sometimes I just don't feel like it. Like, I just want a break, and I'll take a break. You know, I'm not competing for anything. I am doing my little 12-week cut or lean down. So that was another reason why I wanted to vlog this. I want to share something with y'all, and that's going to be about carb cycling. I've started to carb cycle, and this is going to be my second week of carb cycling, although it is, I think, my fifth week into the 12-week challenge. It's something that I kind of decided late to do. I've done it once before, but I didn't do it for very long, and it didn't do it to 100%, so I didn't like the results. Of course, you know, you're not going to get 100% results if you don't put it towards there. So this time I'm doing it right, putting 100% towards it. So I'm going to fix me some coffee because I really need some coffee. And I need something to eat, so I'm going to go ahead and fix my breakfast and get all that ready. I usually do that in the morning, and I go to my little desk and do my journal records, you know, what time I got up, what I'm doing today. I make sure that I finished the day before. I always enter all my macros, my calories, everything like that. So that's what I do in the morning. So I'm gonna get my coffee fixed and some breakfast. I'm not sure what I'm gonna eat today because today is low carb day. And on low carb day, if I eat 3 meals a day, which I normally do, sometimes I'll fit in a third one. But I only can have like 25 grams of carbs on my low carb day. So I think I might have a smoothie. I think we're going to shoot for a smoothie. So let me get all this stuff done, and I will catch y'all in a little bit, and I will share my carb cycling with y'all. Okay? See y'all later.
There's nothing certain because we both checked out. Crazy because we used to bring the best out. Now separation seems like the best route, but it's just something about you I could never lose. It's just something about you I could never lose.
I can't stop falling. I can't see what's in front of me. I feel like I can barely breathe without you. I won't stop crawling. I'm down here on my knees. I'm begging you, please don't leave.
Okay, so my coffee's done. Really needed that. And my smoothie. So I'll just go back and forth drinking between these two until I finish them. And usually what I do now in the mornings, let's get some light in here first. Just a little. Or maybe none at all. We got complications. Alright, now let's go. I love it when it's sunny outside. It makes me feel alive and well and yada yada yada. Anyways, so usually, yeah, when I fix my breakfast, get my coffee, I come sit at my little desk in our camper and fix my journal. I haven't always done a journal. I wanted to do a journal since I started this 12-week deal, just to see, you know, I could log down what I ate, what I didn't eat, what I exercised, how much I exercised, and just kind of like when I get done, go back to see, you know, how my body reacted to certain things. So it's just, I thought it was going to be a good idea because I'm a very forgetful person, so I can't tell you what I ate like 4 days ago. So a journal really helps me. This is my journal. I have several journals. I bought them because when I first started this, I really liked it 4 or 5 weeks ago. And I wanted one for the 12-week, and then I also wanted another one just to have to put anything and everything, anything that I've learned to, you know, jot down in there because, again, I'm forgetful. But this one is strictly day-to-day, in and out, my 12-week logs, and this is what it is. It says, stay fabulous. And of course, it's a ring binder where you can turn all the way over. I hate those ones that aren't like a notebook. So yeah, I have my logs set up for each day, and I just keep going and going. So that's what we're gonna do right now. We're gonna catch up on that. And again, when I get done with this, I will tell y'all more about my carb cycling. So I told you guys that I wanted to tell you about my carb cycling, and I wanted to do a little update on, you know, things that I've changed since the first time, the first week that I started this 12-week challenge. Today is today is day 29. And today is starting my 5th week into my 12 weeks. And I have started seeing some changes and results. Like I said, last week is when I first started the carb cycling. So the weeks before that, I was just, I had just put myself on just a strict low-calorie, low-carb diet, and I knew about carb cycling. I've done it before, but like I said earlier, the first time that I did it a while back, I didn't do it 100%, so of course I didn't get like 100% result, and so I didn't like it. But that was my fault. That wasn't the diet fault. So, carb cycling's not for everyone, but it has become really, really popular to, you know, really lean down and get rid of that excess body fat. So I decided that I wanted to give it a try again, and this time do it 100% instead of what I did last time. So this is going to be my second week of starting it, and last week did really well. What I did was, or maybe I should start with this. If you don't really know what carb cycling is, I'll explain to you a little bit. I'm not going to go like full in detail about it, but carb cycling is basically you have a day of low carbs, and the day after that, then you have a high carb day, and then the day after that, maybe you have like a moderate low carb, and then back to a low carb day again. So you're just going up and down with your carbs, and what it does is, being on like a strict, like low carb diet, you know, for like weeks and weeks and weeks, your body like adapts and gets used to it. So on carb cycling, you have like a low carb day, and you know, your body is like restricted of all these nutrients that it's not getting. And then the next day is basically, if you've ever heard of a refeed, it's basically a refeed day. It's refueling, it's jump-starting your metabolism, and that's because you have a high carb day. And I don't mean it's like a high carb junk food day. I mean like carb cycling, it's supposed to still be clean eating and high carb, you know, of all the good complex carbs, not just pizza and everything that, you know, is a carb and you're like, high carb day, I can have whatever I want. It's not designed that way. You can do it that way if you want. I mean, I'm not here to judge, but by that high carb day, it refeeds your body and gets your metabolism back going, because your metabolism starts to slow down when you don't have a lot of carbs, or you know, you're on a really restrictive diet for a long time. So that low carb day, you know, your body's fatigued, it's tired, you didn't get the proper nutrients, you're restricting yourself. And then the next day when you have a high carb day, then your body gets all happy and just rejuvenates itself. And then the next day you can go to a moderate low carb day, you know, to get your body ready to go back down to the very low. So you go high, moderate, low, and then low. So I will show you, or I will tell you, how I've done it is, most people, when they do their carb cycling, you really want to kind of figure it out around your workout schedule. So my workout schedule is, bear with me, I have to remember this. Mondays I do chest, triceps, and shoulders. Tuesday is legs. Wednesday is back and biceps. And Thursday is cardio only. Friday is legs again. Saturday is cardio only. And Sunday is rest day for me. Now that has kind of changed since the beginning of my first video, which is the beginner guide to the gym, that I kind of gave y'all a little information on that. So what I do, and I'll list it somewhere here on the screen, because it's really kind of hard to just go with what I'm telling you. But so on my leg days are my high carb days. So I have two high carb days for my week, and that is Tuesday and Friday. The reason why I do that is leg days are the workout days that I lift the most. So I want to have, you know, as much energy as I can and to fuel my body with those carbs. But again, on high carb day and any other day, I really like to get in my carbs in the morning around my workout, because normally my day-to-day schedule is to wake up, eat breakfast, drink my coffee, become alive and well. Get my brain started, and then go to the gym. And I'm usually done at the gym by noon to 1, and then I have the rest of the day off to do whatever I want. So I really like to get the majority of my carbs in the morning, breakfast, and if I have at least an hour. We'll say if I have at least 2 hours between my breakfast and my workout, I'll eat something like a protein bar or something. Just something right before my workout that, you know, my body can use as fuel instead of really, you know, tacking or tacking into that muscle mass and using that as energy, it will use the fat in my body and all those nutrients that are in my stomach. So I like to do that. It's able to use the carbs that I just ate as fat rather than my muscle tissue breaking it down and using it as energy. So majority of carbs around your workout, because that's when you sweat a lot. So pause, I gotta get some coffee. All right, so yes, Tuesday and Fridays are my high carb days, and I always follow my high carb days with a moderate low carb day. Why? Because I don't want to freak my body out from going to high to low, then low to high. You yourself can do your own research on carb cycling in orders of how you can do it, what you can do, different things you can do. But this is how I do it. And that is a moderate low carb followed by my high carb day. The only time I have two low carb days back to back is Sunday and Monday. And that's only because Sunday is a complete rest day, so I don't need very many calories, don't need very many carbs that day because I'm not doing anything. I would love to, because that's the only day Copeland is off, and we usually have cheat meal day on Sundays. So he's been really good and trying to eat somewhat healthy, so it helps me. he's not very a clean eater type of person, but he's been very good with my journey and being very supportive. So he's helping me out with that, because when you're on a low carb day on Sunday and it's off day and y'all usually travel and eat really unhealthy foods, it's toying with my mindset, my willpower. So he knows how bad I want this, and I really thank him for supporting me and helping me get through this. But with that being said, today's Monday. Just a reminder, we had pizza yesterday. I only had two slices of Papa John's thin cheese pizza. And no, that is not good complex carbs. That is bad. That's very, very bad carbs. But I haven't really allowed myself to cheat very much here lately for these past 4 weeks. And Sunday I really did somewhat good. I had a very light breakfast and a very light lunch. So even though they were bad carbs, I was somewhat able to afford them, I guess you could say. Kinda. I mean, it's not good, but I only ate two slices. Didn't eat a whole bunch, and I don't eat the leftovers. He takes them to work with him, so that's two slices, that's it. So, yeah, just, again, being real with y'all guys, being honest with y'all guys. I don't want to lie to y'all, don't want to hide anything. I want you to know exactly what I do and the results that I get from it and everything. But, yeah, I just wanted to just to update y'all a little bit on this, because I did tell you at the first video, the beginner guide to the gym, in the intro to that, I did tell you a little bit more about this, and I just kind of wanted to just update you guys and tell you what I'm doing and how it's going. I will have to measure myself. See, here's the deal. I wish I would have started this carb cycle at the very beginning of these weeks, because carb cycling, when you first start, of course, anything, you have to give it some time to, like, you know, let your body, like, work with it. So I was measuring myself every 2 weeks and taking pictures, and that was from, like, the very first week. But since I started carb cycling last week, I kind of put that all on hold, and I'm going off of from last week. So I will wait this week, and then next week I will weigh myself. I will weigh myself. I will measure myself. I won't check my body fat percentage at that time, because I want to give my body a little bit more time to see and change. And I'll probably give myself a month, 4.5-5 weeks, to see what kind of changes my body has taken since I've started my carb cycle. I really hate that I didn't start it on the first week of my 12 weeks. I might turn this into like 14-15 week challenge so I can do like 12 weeks of carb cycling. I don't know. I'll just have to play with it, see how my body reacts. With the first week being down last week, I felt really lean. I felt really de-bloated. I've been focusing on really getting my water intake, which is, I've been shooting for 130 ounces a day. My low ball days have been 85 ounces of water. I don't like the water taste here in Florida, in the town we're at. I've not liked the water taste anywhere, because I am from Oklahoma, our hometown. I like their water. I'm used to their water. I lived there for, when did we start? I don't know. I lived there for like 20-something years, you know, never moved, and then we started traveling like this, and then we realized that their water, there's probably nothing wrong with their water, but we're so used to our own in Wilburton, Oklahoma, and we're so used to our own in Oklahoma, and it just tastes funny to us, so I can't just stick something underneath the faucet and fill my water bottle up and like go to the gym with it, because I like want to gag. So there's nothing wrong with the water. It's just I'm not used to the taste. So I've been buying lemons and like juicing them so I can have like the lemon juice to pour in there. But that kind of gets a hassle, so it's been hectic trying to drink a crap load of water. I drink water bottles and buy like a case of water and have to buy like two cases every week. So it's just a mess. But water really does keep you de-bloated, and it really keeps all those toxins flushed out. So that is number one thing that you know, has really kept me de-bloated. Which is crazy, because yesterday, you know, like I said, I had those two slices of pizza for dinner, and I woke up this morning, and I wasn't like super lean like I have been last week, but I wasn't bloated, and that was kind of strange, because, you know, it was kind of throw off for my body since I hadn't really been cheating much, which, I mean, I guess it's great. I like that my body does that, and before I started this 12-week challenge, that's why I considered myself a flexible dieter. Because, you know, there's times that we're going to go hang out with friends and I'm going to want to have, you know, starchy carbs. And, I don't really want my body to have a negative effect on it. So, before this, when I dieted, flexible dieting, I would eat starchy carbs, in moderation. So, you know, every now and then, you know, I'd throw some in so my body, you know, didn't freak out. you know, on the weekend that maybe we went and hung out with friends and went bowling and, you know, had a basket of fries. yeah, I was super, super excited that, I mean, I've went 5 weeks, well, I guess 4 weeks, 4 weeks with, like, almost, I would say, 85% clean diet, and had those two pizzas, I wish, and my body didn't freak out, so that's good. But definitely not gonna have no more pizza in the near future. so this is kind of turned into a long video. I didn't mean for it to video. And if you can kind of hear, the TV's on. I don't know where the remote is. I can't turn it down. So again, like I said, on the screen, I will put, like, my exercise in combination with my high, moderate, or low carbs. So just so you can kind of see, you know, how I played it out and what I'm doing. So I just wanted to kind of update you guys on what I've been doing with my messy hair, my no makeup face, and my coffee and my smoothie. These are my mornings. I love them. I appreciate them. And I am very blessed that I don't have to work, that I can do whatever I want. And I'm able to do my passion every day, go to the gym and spend as much time as I want there. It's a very blessed life and I'm very grateful for it. But if you don't follow me on social media, on Instagram, I will put my little thing, my name down here. Be sure to follow me on there because I'm always posting on there. And like 90% of it is fitness related or health tips, food tips, all kinds of that stuff on there. So I'm very active on Instagram. I do have Snapchat and I will put that down below too. I do have a Twitter account as well, but I'm old school and I don't really know how to use Twitter. So I mean, I have one, but I'm not on there very much. So I don't recommend going to that. Instagram is your best bet. Do have Facebook, but I use that as a personal thing just to, you know, basically to keep track of people from my hometown and friends with them and interact with them. Instagram is my social media platform account that I do that is, what do you call it, that is public. That's what I'm trying to think of. So be sure to follow me on that. Thank you for watching this video, and if you aren't subscribed to my channel, you need to click the red button below. So be sure to do that if you are a returning subscriber. Thank you guys for all your support. My little bitty channel is growing very, very slowly. So I appreciate that. And I hope you guys have a wonderful Monday. I'm going to be working on this video, and so I'm going to be putting it out hopefully tomorrow. Hopefully. So I will catch y'all guys later in the next video. So